Hi, my name is Jasper Meijering.
And my name is Jeroen Hendricks.
And I'm Thijs de Vos.
As teaching assistants, we are part of the supporting course team of the MOOC Leadership for Engineers. We are standing here in Lecture Hall A of the Faculty of Technology, Policy and Management of the Delft University of Technology. If we have to fit all of you inside this room, we would need 167 lecture halls like this. With more than 25,000 students enrolled in this MOOC, there are more students inside the MOOC than there are currently studying at the Delft University of Technology.
We would like to congratulate you with almost reaching the end of the course. But before it's time for the final exam, we want to give you a brief wrap-up of the last weeks. In week one, Hans and Gedien explained that leadership is highly context-related. You also learned that the three characteristics of the world in which leaders operate are that there is a network of interdependencies, problems are wicked or unstructured, and the world is dynamic. In this week, we also asked you to post cartoons of leadership on the discussion forum. We thought most of them showed what it requires to be a good leader, and some students even made the effort to draw a cartoon themselves. In week two, two mindsets of a leader were discussed, a project-based mindset and a process-based mindset. On the discussion forum, most of you told us which style fits you best. The average answer consisted of a mix of styles due to the fact that leadership is very much context-related, as you learned in week one.
In week two and three, some personal characteristics were covered by Stefan and Surya. Besides, you were taught how to evaluate it on your own strengths and behavior. For us, it was really nice to hear your positive reaction on meditations. Week three elaborated on your personal charter. Your personal charter can really help you during your life and career decisions. Furthermore, we taught you how your emotions work and how they can influence your daily life. Also, we discussed the effect of positive and negative emotions, stress, learned optimism, and the amygdala hijack.
The last chapter of this MOOC was devoted to connecting your learnings from the previous two parts. The theory on highly complex networked environments with your personal characteristics, your strengths, and your weaknesses. We further explained the leadership style that were briefly introduced to you in week two of this MOOC, the clips of Jack, John, Jeff, and Jay. In the light of the triple bottom line, we introduce you another leadership style that is hopefully able to capture the current level of complexity in this world in a better way, sustainable leadership. The assignment of this last chapter was to come up with your own leadership style that you observed in your region, culture, or work environment. We have seen very promising results. We would like to highlight the leadership style provided by Kevin from Peru. He shared the transactional leadership style with us. A transactional leader runs transactions with his staff. In addition to the leadership styles, TU Delft alumnus Peter Lichthart and Dana Kruger infused you with some essential advices to enhance your career opportunities and to improve the quality of your working lives.
We would like to thank you for your participation in this MOOC. We love the collaboration with you guys from all over the world. We want to wish you good luck with the final exam and with your further career. So bye from the TU Delft.
Bye.